round match in the Colosseum Tournament and is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first.
We are back to the Colosseum Tournament. Another first round, and this one is massive. The leader of the Rogue Army, the Hammer Bonza, and one of the biggest matches of his PWA career. He's up against one of the best grapplers in the world. And he's ready.
And his opponent.
And this is one of the moments a lot of people have been waiting for.
Presenting Bullet Club's Rogue Army, Jack J Bonza! Weighing in tonight at 96 kilograms, representing TMDK, he is the New Japan Pro Wrestling World Television Champion, Zack Sabre! Junior!
Chris, there is so much more than an opening round of Colosseum at this match. It is two leaders of two factions that are highly regarded in professional wrestling. The Bullet Club's Rogue Army and the historical TMDK with the front man, Zack Sabre Jr. This is special, Chris.
It's a match of global significance, Rose. There's no denying it. I've never seen Bonza this pensive.
Oh, man. You know, he's got that same face on when he had to look Shingo in the eye. It's that seriousness of, I know I'm going up against someone on another level.
Bonza looking for a bit of courage there by abusing the crowd. It didn't help.
It's Bonza 101, right? Yep. Start arguing with the crowd, it pumps him up. But this is, okay, sit back and enjoy, Chris, because Zack Sabre Jr. is a spectacle. You know that bendy man from Fantastic Four? He's like that.
Mr. Fantastic,
there you
Rose.
Go.
I got to say, he's goddamn beautiful, Zack Sabre Jr.
He's gorgeous. He's gorgeous. You two could be related with that hair.
Well,
you're like a before and after picture.
Yeah, it's only
beautiful
just the hair.
Now, I know there's a lot of people on the internet already complaining, but I'll tell you right now, I'm not calling everything that these two men are about to do, because this is going to be fast and technical beyond my knowledge. Look at this great leg grab there.
This is just
back and forth, isn't it?
Look at the dictionary under Grapple Fest, and that'll be all you need to know.
The transitions of Zack Sabre Jr. are one of the most impressive things. The way he locks, Bonza almost tapped there.
It's the speed at which Sabre Jr. moves, Rose. I had a look at some of his matches recently on YouTube, and I thought my video was on fast forward.
Yeah, right? It's super, super fast. Technical.
And he's imperious, Rose, just imperious. Huge force in British wrestling for so long now.
And also, another person who made a big prediction was Bad Luck Fale himself predicting Jack Bonza to win this tournament. almost telling him to win this tournament.
Instructing him to win.
You better believe Bonza knows he's got to walk out of here tonight with a win no matter what. But Zach is having fun. He went to the harbour yesterday, got a ferry to Manly. Now he's just doing leg walks on Bonza. He's having a great time. He was telling me, I got a chance to talk to Zach before the show, and he was telling me how much he loves this venue. Tells him, it reminds him of the Progress venue, the ballroom over in England. He said it's got that same energy. This feels like a special place. The words he said to me, it's such an honor to have him here in Colosseum, but to hear him say things like that really reaffirms what we've believed for many years, Chris, that this is a special home. And a special company in PWA. Look at this.
It was a marvellous reflection. He then said, please stop talking to me if I heard that conversation correctly.
Bruv. Talk to me, bruv, I think.
How do you scout this man, Rose? I mean, Bonza,
mate,
a great grappler, an Australian legend in grappling, but he is up against arguably the greatest technical wrestler on the planet.
And I mean, on the planet. I mean, you've seen some of his recent matches. The one with Brian Danielson, a lot of people were talking about, this is what he does, he just said, this is what I do. Bonza needs to slow this down. But so far, that is the first intent from Bonza that I feel has been nefarious in this match.
Yeah, he was trying to go toe-to-toe and it wasn't working.
It wasn't working at all.
He's back in, I wouldn't call it his happy place, Bonza, because he's never happy, but his comfortable place.
It was a minor distraction, but still, you can see Bonza. Crowd is alive for Zack Sabre Jr. A lot of people here to see him. That leg drop just cracked Zack Sabre Jr. Right across the right cheek. You could feel that from here, knees to the back.
Yeah, look, I think this is a good shift by Bonza. He wasn't going to be able to match Sabre Jr. too much longer.
Shout out Tom Jeffries on Twitter. What an incredibly fun show so far. I think Zack Sabre Jr. is my pick to win it. Fellow countryman and all. I mean, you've got to go for your country, boy.
Oh, yeah. And Tom Roberts has joined us because he now knows that it's hashtag PWA on fight to be part of this conversation tonight at Colosseum Night 1.
Goodness. Did you see that? Zach just ran full speed into a Bonza elbow. And I think that just changed the conversation of this match a little bit. Bonza's a Tory. That means spelling? Tory spelling? She was all right in that, what was it, Beverly Hills? Oh. That good.
I'll talk you through English politics at another time, my friend.
Tom Roberts on Twitter, Chris, says, Rose and Chris should just make up the move names like they know them because this is about to get insane. Yeah. Yeah, I'll just do that.
Yeah, I know you think the Remy Sunak is something you eat, but anyway.
Oh, Zach's hit him with the bobbity boo. Here we go. Oh, goodness. Almost snapping that arm here. You can see that Zach's feeling it though. That club, those clubs in the chest, he's grabbing his sternum. But again, a million and one ways he has to get out and hurt you is gotta be terrifying as a competitor. And Bonza might have just had his left arm broken.
Oh yeah. Great leg sweep there, followed by the stomp.
And that appreciation from the PWA faithful, they came to see this level of grappling. And this is what the Colosseum Tournament is about. If you're around the world watching live right now, this is your first time. Now you get it. The Colosseum Tournament is about the best grapplers in this world.
And the world is watching on Fight TV Plus, Rose.
Absolutely.
Back elbow there from Bonza.
Nice grab there by Zack Sabre Jr. Look at that, a submission wrapped around the ropes. Referee Hannah's going to have to break that. It's not legal, but he's flexing while he's doing it. This man is so impressive. They just love him. The leader of TMDK, the Mighty Don't Kneel, have been such a faction in Australia for so many years, boosted to even higher level now with people like Zack Sabre Jr. Helping them grow. Robbie joining recently. Oh, nice drop toe hold though by Bonza. Crocodile rolls him through. Grabbing the head, oh my God!
I'll credit Bonza, he's hanging in there.
He is, Bonza can take a beating that better than a lot of people in PWA. He can take a lot of punishment. And I think that's the lesson Zach is about to learn. Because a lot of his matches, Zach would do what he just did and wrap it up. But then he was just grabbed and thrown head first into a turnbuckle. Yeah, and that's the scary part of Bonza, right, Chris? Just the battering ram of a human. Again, he goes for that arm, but Bonza catches it into an ankle lock. Oh, there he is, the bendy man himself.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely. Locking the leg, bringing back the arm, wrenching on the midsection there. Bonza grabs the leg, though. That's very smart by Bonza, grabbing that right leg. Again, back into the ankle lock. It's a bold strategy to try and tap out Zack Sabre Jr., but Bonza's going for it. If he needs to link these fingers, if Zach gets those fingers unlocked, he can extend that arm. There's a pin, though. Bonza's smart. Zach lifts the arm. He knows he's got to keep that shoulder off the ground. Bonza now with boots to the head. Bonza literally just stomping his way out of that submission. Bang!
Big forearm there.
Ouch.
I tell you, those Bonza ankle locks, blinking, you missed them, Rose.
No.
Sabre Jr. able to get out of them so quickly.
Oh, he knows. I mean, he scouted Bonza. He knows. He knows that ankle lock is scary. He's also got the napalm thunder driver. Bonza's starting to struggle with his strength a little bit. And it's now Zach to get some holds on. This is an armbar in the middle of the ring. Bonza's got to look out.
We got the fingers.
Another smart reversal by Bonza, getting the upper hand, getting that overbody weight again and going back to those stomps. But Zach literally just wrenches your wrist, and a man the size of Bonza just squealed and hit the ground like a sack of potatoes. I can't even tell you how painful some of these are. The long legs of Bonza, though, getting a break there.
Both men just taking an opportunity to catch their breath at the moment.
Yeah, there's been a lot of energy expelled in the first part of this match. The crowd and the competitors in the ring have expelled a lot of energy. The hype is real. Well, you know both these men want to represent Rogue Army and TMDK. And this is potentially just one of the biggest matches of the entire weekend. And it's first round, Chris. Look at this, Zach. Look at what he does. It's magical. But Bonza was ready with another ankle lock.
This one he's got in, Rose.
He's got it really locked in, and now he drags Zach to the middle of the ring. The long man that Zack Sabre Jr. is, he's got to find another creative way to get out of this. Oh, look at this. He's trying to use his own leg weight to leverage the ankle out of the lock. Bonza sees it coming. Locks in something else as well. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. I'm going to call that the welcome to Sydney. Zack Sabre Jr., you've got to get to him, still talking a massive load of crap while he's getting locked up in something that could end his tournament. Zach's not having it! He's reversed the own submission. This has got to be killing Bonza. He can't do anything without Zach having an answer for it. Look at this, they're both just answering back. This is great stuff. This is what professional wrestling is all about.
The aerobic nature of this contest, not to Bonza's liking, though, Rose. I mean, ZSJ, he doesn't really sweat. He just glistens in the ring, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's a very shiny man. The hair really pops.
You mentioned Robbie Eagles. He'll be watching from Japan. Shattered he can't be here tonight, Rose.
Oh, shout out to the great Robbie Eagles. It's not the same without him here, but he's over in New Japan, preparing for the Super Junior Tag Tournament with Kosei Fujita, who just spent some time here in Australia. I played a bit of Fortnite with Fujita. It was good fun.
Fuji was great.
I taught him how to say winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Yeah, what a talent.
He's a great guy. Wish him all the best.
there's almost a mild approval that chop from Zack Sabre Jr.
Did Zack Sabre Jr. just give a Yelp rating for that chop? Gave it a 3 out of 5.
Yeah.
Would go again. Uppercuts.
Need some work.
Uppercuts. An English specialty. Bang. Oh. Trying to chop. I think this is a mistake by Zach. You cannot play the strength game with Zach. This is working in Bonza's favor at the moment. It's just hurting his limbs that he's submitting you. Jesus. Wow.
Well, he's got Sabre Jr. fired up, Rose.
This is working in Bonza's favour. He's got Zach angry underneath. Zach goes! Oh, an explosive double underhook German. Oh, the penalty kick. This could be it. One, two. Oh, and a kick out by Bonza, staying alive. And that penalty kick almost got Zack Sabre Jr. to win. Chris, we're a while into this match and I still can't believe I'm calling a Zack Sabre Jr. match.
No, it's fantastical. It's almost ethereal. It's imaginary. It's pro wrestling. Listen to this crowd.
I missed about three words in that. I've got to tell you, though, it's a great honour for us to be able to call. You and I have called every Colosseum match that's ever happened. But the privilege we get to call such athletes as Zack Sabre Jr. is just... it's hard to explain. Bonza again, the strength of Bonza just turfed Zach to the outside.
That surprised me, Rose. He did that with some aplomb, Bonza, and he's gone outside the ring to join Sabre Jr. And
the thing I'll say about Zach as well, Chris, he always seems to stay calm. He's been in a lot of these situations before. Oh, look out! Oh, my goodness! Bonza just whipped Zack Sabre Jr. into the wall of the production table back there. I think this idea of winning this fairly has gone out the window, and Bonza's just thrown him against a wall. He's not going to go for a count out, is he? Chris, he's looking for a count out win in the Colosseum tournament.
Well, it's the Iron Mercy, Rose. He'll take it.
Referee Hanna will start the count. Bonza's going to take this count out. We're up to seven. Oh, Zach has gone up and he slipped on eight. This could be not like this. The rogue army's not going to win on a count out. Zach's out. Oh, he's in on nine and runs straight into a clothesline. Bonza with the win. Throw. No. A kick out at two. Sabre stays alive. Wow, Bonza waited for him to come in on nine and absolutely lariated him back to next week. Another huge lariat to the back of the head now. This is big trouble for Zack Sabre Jr. Bonza has gone outside the normal playbook, brought him into the rogue army's world in a way. And now Zach, I mean, this would send ripples around the wrestling world if Zack Sabre Jr. was knocked out round one by a rogue army member. 3-0! A kick out of two. And Zack Sabre Jr. stays alive again.
What a great couple of minutes for Jack J. Bonza, Rose.
Oh, wow, that was incredible. Bonza is bringing his A game tonight.
He remains hampered by that left arm, but he is in command right now.
And neither man want to go back to their group after this and say, I got knocked out round one. So you better believe it, him, Bonza. Zack Sabre Jr. grabs the ropes. Zach, oh, gets German suplex by Bonza, but he's up and full of energy. Oh, and Bonza has absolutely clobbered him. Shades of what Grimm did earlier tonight. He might just brute force his way through this. Again, he's going for the napalm thunder driver. He has ended people with this. Zach rolls through, grabs the hand. Look at that. Oh, look at that catch. Oh, and the strength of Bonza out of the pin. He's holding the whole weight of Zach. Oh, nice drop into the headlock. Zach rolls through. Look at this technicality. One, two, three.
Here's your winner, Zack Sabre Jr.
Chris, that was an absolute classic, a wrestling masterclass. And Zack Sabre Jr. with the last little trump card gets a technical roll up and the win against Bonza.
Bonza changed the tempo to great effect. But the technical prowess of Zack Sabre Jr. won out in the end as he takes the plaudits from the PWA crowd. Take a bow, Zack Sabre Jr.
He's won through the first round. Zack Sabre Jr. is off to tomorrow's round two and moves on in the Colosseum tournament. And now Bonza has to go away and explain why he's been eliminated round one.
My people in the front. My city, my house, my show.
Through the table!
J
October 13th. It's on.
Never, 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 never